The basic drawing tools in Photosounder are quite simple and their function is mostly obvious. The white spray sprays in white, the dark spray darkens, the flashlight brightens, the smart eraser erases in a smart way, and the rectangle darkens or brightens pixels in an area shaped like a rectangle. That's about all there is to these tools, except for a couple of things. The first one is the harmonic modifier. When enabled, your spray tool draws the same thing at every harmonic frequency. This is useful both for creating harmonic sounds or for transforming every harmonic of sounds, such as instruments and voice, all at once. The other thing is the magnet modifier. It merely helps to draw right on a line when editing a sound. Photosounder uses a layer system in many ways comparable to the system used by Photoshop. The layers represent a stack of images combined together from the bottom to the top. These images are combined together mathematically according to the blending mode assigned to them. By default, the layers are simply added together, which means that the final image you see and hear is the mathematical sum of each image in the stack. In this example, if the blending mode of the top layer is changed to multiplication, then the pixels in the bottom layer are multiplied by those in the top layer. In the case of multiplication between two layers, the order of the layers doesn't matter. However, it does matter for modes such as division or subtraction, which is why there are modes where the order of the operation is reversed. Most blending modes are simply and fairly self-explanatory, except the convolution and propagation modes. Unlike all the other modes, they do not simply operate on single pixels as they use convolution between layers. The concept of convolution between entire image isn't very familiar as it's not usually used in image editing. It's also a difficult concept to explain and those convolution modes have a lot of different uses, which is why they will be the subject of another video. Most audio editing programs offer effects for you to apply to sounds. Photosounder doesn't. Instead, it offers operations, simple mathematical operations. Together with the rest of the editing tools, they allow you to craft your own effects. For example, Photosounder doesn't offer any kind of equalizer. However, you can draw your own equalization curve, then turn it into an equalization layer by using an operation to fill everything from the left of the image to your curve, then average every horizontal line of this image. By filling every pixel between your curve and the left edge of the image with white, you make it so that each line of your image has as many white pixels as the distance from your curve to the left edge of the image. Then, by averaging each line, every pixel of each line has a value proportional to the number of white pixels it had in its line. So when you multiply this layer with another layer that represents the sound you want to equalize, each frequency band, represented by an horizontal line of pixels, is multiplied by the value in each band of pixel. Therefore, some frequency bands become brighter and louder, while others are darkened and silenced. There are many traditional audio processing effects that can be crafted using combinations of these three particular operations, such as compression, expanding, limiting, noise gating, de-essing, or sidechain compression. The other operations are somewhat more straightforward. Invert is about the same thing as the invert function in most editing software. Mask invert is a convenient operation to isolate the parts of a sound without having to deal with layers. You can erase part of a sound, and mask invert will give you the opposite of what you did. So if you erase an instrument, you can isolate it in one click using mask invert. Horizontal flip will reverse the time of an image. Vertical flip will reverse everything in frequency in an image, so that basses become trebles, melodies are played upside down, and harmonic overtones become undertones. Normalize to 1 changes the intensity of the layer, so that the brightest pixel has a value of exactly 1. Horizontal normalization flattens the spectrum of an image, so that every frequency has the same overall loudness. And vertical normalization flattens the envelope of an image. Both operations are quite useful when editing the spectral profile of a sound or when editing the dynamics of a sound. The 1 divided by x, square and square root operations do what it says on the tin to each individual pixel. Finally, the group to nearest semitone operation groups all the pixels of each line onto the line that represents the nearest semitone. This is useful when drawing notes and you want the notes to be perfectly flat and in tune. But it can also be used to achieve strange effects. The Move tool moves an entire layer around. This means it can change its position in time if moved horizontally and pitch shift it if moved vertically. Holding the Shift key ensures that you can only move the layer either horizontally or vertically. The gamma setting affects the brightness of the pixels of layer. Turning it to the right makes the whole image brighter relative to its brightest parts. Turning it the other way has the opposite effect. Operations square root and square are equivalent to a gamma of half and a gamma of 2. The layer intensity knob only appears when more than one layer is present and is used to change the overall intensity of a layer relative to that of other layers.